Hi everyone, I'm Chavi. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'll be discussing about Article 14 of Indian Constitution, which talks about right to equality. And also the important thing about this article is that, as we all know, that Article 14 to Article 18 are the articles which talks about right to equality. But Article 14 is the article which talks about right to equality in a more general way. And other articles talks about right to equality in a more specific form. And also, second point of distinction is that Article 14 applies to all citizens, non-citizens also, but rest of the articles of right to equality applies only to citizens. So it is very important to understand Article 14. Let's begin. And also, one more important thing is, if you want to expand your knowledge of law, and if you want to keep updated with law, and if you want to revise your knowledge of law, then I am having my Insta handle named Chavi's Notes, where I daily upload MCQs and you can also play them and update your knowledge. So let's begin with the article, that is Article 14. Now, Article 14 of Indian Constitution runs as that the state shall not deny to any person equality before law or equal protection of laws within the territory of India. See, before jumping into the explanation of the section, I would suggest you that please try to find yourself that what are the keywords in the section or article. So it would be very beneficial for you. You should always try to understand and interpret yourself the article or the section, whatever it may be. So that it would be very beneficial for you, and please understand that what is there in these two lines that the book has to explain it in 20 pages. So that's why I would suggest you please try to find out keywords for yourself before jumping into the explanation. Now, coming back to the topic, so this article which talks about right to equality, there are some keywords which are very important. The first word is that any person is used here, which clearly means that this article includes all, that is citizens as well as non-citizens, natural persons as well as juristic person, legal persons also. For example, companies, associations, all these are included in this article. So now the next two most important terms in this article are, that is equality before law and equal protection of laws. So let's first discuss about what is equality before law. So equality before law is an English concept, and equal protection of laws is an American concept. And we are blessed and we are lucky that we, in our constitution, we are having both the concepts. So let's begin with the first concept, that is equality before law. So equality before law basically means that no one is above law. This is also known as Dicey's concept of rule of law. He says that from prime minister down to a constable, everyone is equal in the eyes of law. It doesn't matter how high or low your rank is. It doesn't matter what is your position, what is your status. Everybody is equal in the eyes of law, and everybody has to go from the same rights and liabilities if they're made. From the second expression, that is equal protection of laws. Equal protection of laws, as I earlier mentioned, it is American concept, and it is also known as a positive concept of equality. And what is unique about this concept is that it says that there has to be an equal treatment of people in equal circumstances, which clearly mentions that equals should be treated equally and unequals must be treated differently or unequally. And Aristotle has explained that there is nothing as unequal as treating unequals equally. So this, what this term promotes is that as we all know that in a society there are different kinds of people and there are variety of people. So that's why absolute equality is physically impossible. That's why what this term tries to explain is that we have to classify people in certain groups who are equal, but that classification has to be reasonable. And that is why this term has also laid down two tests for the classification. Let's discuss them. Now the two tests are, the first one is intelligible differentia and rational nexus. So the first one means that that which will differentiate between the people who are grouped together to the rest of the people. So classification basically. And the second test is rational nexus with this object sought to be achieved. See, why we'll classify people? There has to be certain objective for that classification. So that classification and that objective, there has to be rational nexus, which means there has to be reasonableness, there has to be reasonable relation. So these are the two tests for that. And also classification, जैसे for example मैंने जैसे बताया था कि not everyone are equal. So for example there are different set of laws for lawyers, there are different set of laws for doctors, and also like Sikh community जो है, जो Sikh people जो हैं उनको they are exempted from wearing helmet while riding the motorcycle. So these are the classification. So this was the traditional concept of equality. Now comes the new concept of equality, which was developed from the case of E.P. Royappa versus State of Tamil Nadu. So in this case, what was held was that equality is a dynamic concept. It cannot be confined into traditional limits. And what was held was that equality and arbitrariness are basically sworn enemies. They are completely different from each other. If an act is arbitrary, which means that it does not mean equality. And also, on one hand, equality talks about republic state, and on the other hand, arbitrariness talks about implies about monarchy. So now the new concept of equality is based on the doctrine of arbitrariness. So that's all for today's video. I hope the concept of Article 14, that is right to equality, is clear now. That's all for today's video. Thank you so much. Bye bye.